So, based on these figures, I guess you'd call the Myac trial a success.
20 patients with reduced clotting. Hell yes.
Well, I'll shoot these back to our auditors. Hopefully we can bump the sample number up to 50.
Excellent. Well, if it isn't my hero.
Well, shucks, ma'am, it weren't nothing.
You were so great with Libby last night, you deserve a reward.
Okay, how about this? You're about to go off duty, and I'm not required back at the office.
Have you been snooping at my rosters again?
So, we head to the hot pools, private spa, gourmet picnic.
You have no idea how lovely that sounds.
But
Libby's in a state. I promised I'd look after her.
Superheroes need looking after too.
I know. Next weekend, it'll be just us. No family dramas, I promise.
Ignore me. I miss you, that's all.
I could never ignore you. What did they find?
A previous retinal detachment and a slight swelling on my optic nerve.
And that's what's causing the problems?
No.
What do they think it is?
They're referring me to a retinal specialist and a neurologist for a CT scan. But don't panic, it's more to rule out other things.
Other things? You mean a tumour?
There might be a mass pressing on some nerves.
Chris.
Well, you know, it could be anything. They haven't even ruled out migraines.
Just promise me you'll take it easy. No stress, no long hours, no surgery.
I'll do what I can.
This is serious. You could make things worse, not to mention putting your patients at risk.
You're a neurologist now, are you?
Talk to Huia. She'll understand. I'll come with you.
There's nothing to talk about. And until there is, we're both keeping quiet about this. Both of us.
Yes, Pop.
What?
We are taking our next big step as a couple.
Yeah?
Dinner with Tony and Chris. Try and sound a bit interested.
I'm sorry. You tell me where and when. I will endeavour to be there.
Your place tomorrow night.
My place.
Well, don't worry, you won't have to lift a finger. And with Claire and Baxter at mine.
What about Scarlett?
Well, we ignore the fact that she's being vile and we continue to do normal couple things, you know, squabble over which wine, drink too much and say embarrassing things.
Are you sure that Chris and Tony are up for this?
Well, Tony's Huia's friend, but she's my friend too, and they need to get used to us as a couple. Everyone does.
Yeah, okay, okay.
I just want someone else to be on our side for once. Is that too much to ask?
No, of course not.
It wasn't so bad when you were single. I didn't feel like such a loser then.
You're not a loser. You're a clever, together chick who knows what she wants and goes for it.
I want a George. Look where that got me. Well rid of him, thank goodness. Easy to say now. Now he's just a cheat and a coward. In London, he was like proof that there was a God.
Oh, please.
Seriously, Tarns, I have dated nothing but dropkicks for years. And then, all of a sudden, this suave, mature man seemed really into me. And I really did love him. In a city of more than 7 million people, the only one I could manage to land was an old fruit in search of a cover story.
It's weird hearing you like this. You're always so sure of yourself.
Well, that's what a mental health day will do for you. Bottoms up.
Look, after Mark, I never thought I'd find anyone good. But I did. And you will too. Guess you've just got to be patient.
Never one of my strong points. It's good to talk, though.
Yeah, we haven't been doing enough of that. I'll open another bottle.
Hey, thought I'd join the party. I brought bubbles and deli snacks, including the world's best brownies. Looks like I'm just in time.
Oh, good. Needed to see you. Change of plan. They've roped me into theatre, so I've got Del covering wards.
Sure. What's up?
Acute admission from ED. Fempop bypass. It's all a bit sudden, wasn't it, Mr. Merton?
You're not joking, love.
ED this morning, surgery this afternoon. You'll be dancing the two-step once Dr. Warner's finished with you. He's the best.
I didn't think Chris was operating today.
Yeah, he scheduled it a few hours ago. Come on, Twinkle Toes. Let's be having you.
No open wounds, no obvious scarring.
Sorry to disappoint you.
So what did Tony say? Did you go nuts or what?
Well, I got a telling off, but to be honest, babe, it was nothing serious.
No way. Tony was so angry.
She must have just calmed down by the time I got back there. Or maybe She realised that I was actually doing a good thing for Howie after all.
I think you just got lucky, that's all. But if you keep interfering with patients' lives, your luck's gonna run out.
You see it as interfering, babe. I see it as helping.
Well, there are plenty of ways to help somebody. Ways that won't put a black mark on your record or get you sacked.
But I wasn't, so it's cool. Hello? Oh, hey, mate, how's it going?
Yeah.
What? Well, how did that happen? Okay, then. Yeah, thanks a lot. See ya.
What was that all about? Bex?
Howie, he did a bunk from Serenity the minute that he was unsupervised. I told you so. You don't have to say it.
I'm glad you changed your mind. Always good to be back at the feet of the master. So I've never assisted on a fempop before. Is there anything in particular I need to look out for?
Exposing the femoral and popliteal arteries is pretty straightforward, but the subcutaneous tunneling can be a bit tricky.
Like I said, I'm glad you're here. Nice old bloke. Sad story too.
Oh?
Yeah, him and his wife were like these RSA stalwarts. You know, they literally lived in the place. Then she died, he's devastated. But he picks himself back up and decides to honour her memory by taking over their social club.
Giving him a sense of purpose.
Yeah, but then his leg gets so bad he's housebound.
Yeah, nothing worse than feeling like a waste of space. Right then, let's do this.
Man. Sorry, Libby wasn't there.
Off sick. But I'm glad to see you. I was just thinking that we should catch up for a drink or something. I've been in hibernation too long.
Sounds great.
What about tomorrow?
I can't. Dinner with Craig and Sarah.
Don't feel weird about it. You don't have to stop being friends with them because of me.
Well, actually, that isn't the reason I came to see you.
What is it?
Chris. He's probably going to divorce me for this, but there's something you need to know.
Blood pressure was down so lightly.
Better get a move on.
Well, you're good to go.
Swab count 10. Scalpel, doctor?
Thank you.
Chris, is there a problem?
Well, we're back in Chorking Street tomorrow at the same time. Later today, Miss Marple investigates a triple murder inspired by a nursery rhyme. That's at 3:35 this afternoon here on RTE1.